Hello guys, you are welcome back to my channel. In today's video is how the Minister of Niger Delta Affairs, Senator Godswill Akpabio and his entourage paid a visit to the Olu of Warri, the Omoba of Warri Kingdom designate. Guys, just stay tuned and watch the video. Don't forget to like, don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to stay connected to this channel, guys.
Long live the Olu of Warri Kingdom. Amen.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I want to on behalf of the Omoba of Warri Kingdom, welcome His Excellency Chief Godswill Obot Akpabio and his team to Warri Kingdom. I want to, before we commence proceeding, invite one of our chief, Chief Mene Brown, to lead us in prayer before we commence our delegation. Chief Brown, no say Mene.
Our Heavenly Father, we acknowledge you as the King of the universe, as the one by whom all things are established and there is progress. Thank you for what you are doing in Warri Kingdom. Thank you for bringing at this point the Honorable Minister serving Nigeria, of which we are part. Thank you, you granted him safety as he traveled here. And he's also here to ensure that things are held together so that his tenure will be fruitful, will be successful. We pray, Father, that our discussions here, no matter how fleeting and informal it might be, he will use it to bring good fruit from it. Help him to succeed in his appointment. We pray too that Omoba himself, you have already put on the trajectory for us, you will lead him to a crowning period and lead him to reign in peace and prosperity for our kingdom.
Amen.
Thank you, gracious Father.
Thank you.
Let us be your name. We pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Your Excellency, son of Niger Delta, one of our own, a seasoned administrator, a one-time commissioner for Chieftaincy Affairs, commissioner for Works. As governor, he was an uncommon transformer. He is a motivator, a man of good will, former governor, former senator, and in fact he was the minority leader in the Senate, and now minister for Niger Delta. Ladies and gentlemen, he is one of our own, and we welcome him to Warri Kingdom. On behalf of the Yomoba and the entire people of Warri Kingdom, we say welcome, and we are happy that you are here. And we know that as a transformer, we will receive the dividend of your good work. Chief, God's will, Apabio, C-O-N, we welcome you. At this point, ladies and gentlemen, may I invite His Excellency to give us his brief speech, and thereafter, we have the private meeting with the Yomoba. I welcome you.
The Yomoba of Warri Kingdom, and our deputy. I have been with the regent and all the high chiefs in the kingdom. And we have interacted for the past 1 hour, 1 or 2 hours. We have discussed so many issues. The first is that we observe the minute silence in honor of our late teacher, the Okojame Ikewo, the Olu Obori, who has traveled to join his ancestors to wait for us, and all of us will take their vote. So let me, on behalf of my dear President, on behalf of myself, and my entire, and the good people of Niger Delta that represent, also use this opportunity to condole you and to say that God Almighty will grant you the strength to bear this irreplaceable loss. May God also endow you with wisdom to assist to move the entirety of Warri Kingdom forward. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I thought that there was no way I could enter Warri Kingdom and then enter the palace, meet with the regent and all the high chiefs without coming to pay respect. In line with tradition, that's why I was holding my heart to pray respect to you. But the tradition says we should not wear hats in front of you. So immediately you came in your majesty, I had to do so. But I'm very, very confident that yes indeed, we will celebrate with you on the day of recognition. And we look forward to celebrating constantly with you. Because I'm already at my age, at this stage we count downwards, we don't count upwards. Otherwise I would have said that I will celebrate with you when you are 50 years on the journey. If I don't make it, I think I will make the same decision. I also celebrate with you. But most importantly, to assure you of our prayers and our continual support for this kingdom. And to thank the late Olu Obori for the discipline, the peace that we have enjoyed in this kingdom. In spite of the fact that you are an oil-bearing community and you contributed so much, not just to Delta State, but to Nigeria, this you have not been boastful about it. You have not been showing up. You have not been instructive. Instead, we have continued with constructive engagement, and that is part of what I saw today. I must say I've been to many places, but I've never seen such an organized and disciplined group of people as the people of your kingdom. I don't want to say more, but I assure you that we will continue to support you. I will be there with you all the way. If you can't do any other thing, we'll put that rest on our knees and pray to God that when that time comes, by your rest, we'll bring prosperity to our kingdom. We'll bring peace to our kingdom. And bring peace to your neighbors. And continue to give you strength of character and good health in body and in mind. So I extend the compliments of Mr. President to you and the compliments of your brother, the ministers, and other people in the United Caribbean. And I assure you that you are not alone in this journey. And especially I want to thank the High Chiefs. The King is the oldest, whether he's 10 years old or not. So as the oldest man in the United Kingdom today, Omoba, he is the oldest. But then you have people with great wisdom who have acquired it over the years, sub 70, sub 80. There's no way you can lack. You are already surrounded by everything you need. And all you need now is just the grace of God Almighty. So when you raise your hand, whatever you bless, you bless. Whatever you cause, it's caused. Amen. Maybe so in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Amen.